Are you ready? Let's go. Download SKYUI from Nexus Mods. Now download SKYUI Difficulty Persistence Fix. Now download MCM Helper. You'll see why in a minute. In Mod Organizer 2, visit the Download section. Double-click on SKYUI, click Manual to check the content of data looks valid, and click OK. Now double-click on SKYUI Difficulty Persistence Fix. Enable both of these in the left-hand pane. Now double-click MCM Helper. Ensure you enable this too. Now let's move all three up into the second category, Overhaul and UI. SKYUI first, Difficulty Persistence Fix underneath it, and MCM Helper underneath that. In the Downloads window on the right, right-click and select Hide Installed to keep it tidy. Now visit the Plugins tab and click Sort. With this complete, close the window. Now, because we have MCM Helper installed, you may remember from a previous video there was an option under XP32's installation that allowed us to select MCM as an option. So now, right-click on XP32, select Reinstall. With the pop-up window, select XPM SSE Latest, like before. Only under In-Game Customizing, select Race Menu plus XPM SSE MCM, the top option, whereas before we selected the third option. At the end, click Replace. With XP32 updated to allow the MCM management, open NEMESIS and click Update Engine. Once that is completed, click Launch NEMESIS Behavior Engine. Whilst waiting, feel free to hit that subscribe button. There are plenty more tutorials on their way. Now, let's run Skyrim through SKSE. Once in game, we'll be able to look at how SKYUI has changed our interface. Whilst we are here, select the Start menu and visit the System tab. You will see an option called Mod Configuration. Under Mod Configuration, you should see a SKYUI option, along with an XPM SSE option, thanks to our reinstallation of XP32. Under SKYUI, you should be able to make adjustments according to your preferences. Now I want you to take note of how the character moves here, as this will become important in a second. It's not great, so let's do something to change that. Exit Skyrim. Now visit Nexus Mods again and download TrueHUD. You will see that it requires MCM Helper and SKYUI, which we now have installed. Now download True Directional Movement. You will see now, the order of downloading and installing these is important, as they rely on mods we previously have installed. Now download Animation Cue Fix. Now download Paired Animation Improvements. And finally, download Open Animation Replacer. Open Animation Replacer requires Animation Cue Fix and Paired Animation Improvements. You see why the order is important here. Open Animation Replacer essentially replaces DAR. Now let's go to MO2 and install them. Double-click on TrueHUD, check Manual, and ensure the data path is valid, and install. Check the box to enable the mod, Then drag and drop underneath Overhaul and UI, ensuring it follows MCM Helper. Now install True Directional Movement. And enable it onto Animation Queue Fix. Again, check in manual and make sure the data is valid. Enable. Now paired animation improvements. Enable. And finally, open Animation Replacer and enable that too. Now we want to move these four mods up under Animation Framework. So let's drag and drop them in the order we installed them. True Directional Movement first, which will sit below XP32. Then Animation Queue Fix underneath that, paired Animation Improvements under Animation Queue Fix, and open Animation Replacer last. Now visit the Plugins tab and click Sort once again. Allow Loot to run. Close out of Loot and run Nemesis. Before you click Update Engine, we have installed True Directional Movement, which comes with a couple of extra plugins. Select the boxes for the directional movement options in this window above. Click Update Engine. If you're finding the series helpful, please give us a thumbs up to help support the channel. Now click Launch Nemesis Behavior Engine. Once complete, you can close Nemesis. Now we can launch Skyrim once again through SKSE. You might notice a pop-up window from Open Animation Replacer. We don't need to worry about that right now, but Shift and O will open the window for it. Load back into your game. Now let's take a look at what that's done for us. If you remember how the character used to move about, you'll notice this is quite an improvement. It's subtle, but much more fluid. This is just one of the many things we'll cover to bring Skyrim into the modern day gaming world. Now open up your menu again and visit Mod Configuration. You should have four different windows here. As you can see, mine only shows two at the moment. Should this ever happen to you, just try exiting your game and reloading. It's also important to know you might have to wait a moment or two for the Mod Configuration menus to be recognized. You may notice in the top left-hand corner, MCM gives a little notification that it's registered two new menus. If we go to System, down to Mod Configuration, we'll see all four: SKYUI, True Directional Movement, True HUD, and XPM SSE. If you go under True Directional Movement, you'll notice the options for Leaning, Head Tracking, and Target Lock have Installed next to their name. This is because we installed the plugins through Nemesis. And if you want to see what True HUD looks like, here's me drastically trying to take on a giant. You can see the change in the health bars and the damage bars above the enemies. Our modded build is really starting to take shape. Perfect time for a brew.